Hey everyone, Howard Pinsky here with a very fun Photoshop tutorial where we're going to be creating an animated GIF from this photo that was released recently by NASA that's making its way around the internet. Mainly because if you take a look right up here at the top middle, there's this object that no one really knows what it is. It looked like some metallic object. And some say it fell off the rover as it was descending, some say it's a natural piece of metal like iron that's in the Mars surface, or some people say, well, it's an alien artocraft. So we are going to be creating an enhancement GIF, kind of like you see in CSI and all those other TV shows. Obviously, this technology doesn't really exist, but we're going to pretend, because that's what Photoshop is for. So let's go ahead and begin. So to start off this project, we want to go ahead and reveal our timeline, as that's where we're going to be doing our animation. And you can do this in one of two ways. You can either double click on the timeline tab at the bottom of your workspace, or you can activate it under the window menu at the top of your screen. And once the timeline is visible, you want to go ahead and press the Create Video Timeline button. Now you may see Create Frame Animation. If you do, press the arrow to the right and press on the Create Video Timeline option. Now I will note, because I do see this issue come up a lot, if your computer isn't strong enough, if your graphics card doesn't have enough memory, or if your drivers are out of date, you may not have this option available to you at all. So go ahead and try and update Photoshop, update your drivers, and then try again. Otherwise, your computer may just not be strong enough to handle the features that are available in Photoshop CS6. So let me go ahead and press Create Video Timeline, and here is the timeline where we're going to be doing our animation. All of our layers will appear here, and we can go ahead and expand it to see exactly what they contain. I'm going to go ahead and collapse this just for now, and what we want to do first is create the first layer that we're going to be working with. And that layer is going to be the magnification of that shiny object that's appearing at the top. So to do that, I'm going to start with my rectangular marquee tool, which I can find in my tools bar to the left, and I'm going to make a simple square selection by holding down my shift key around this object, right about here, and I can hold down my space bar at any time to move that selection around. So I'm going to leave that selection right about there. And when the selection has been made, I want to turn this into a layer. And I can very quickly do that by holding down my Command key on the Mac, Control key on Windows, and then pressing the J key on my keyboard. And you can see in the Layers panel, we now have Layer 1. And if I go ahead and move it, you can see that it only contains what was inside that selection. That's exactly what we want in order to animate this layer. And before I animate anything, I always like to convert those layers into a smart object. This just ensures that the original pixels are saved, just in case we have to go back to them and make changes later on. And I can do that by right-clicking on the layer in the Layers panel and choosing the Convert to Smart Object option. And you can see there's the smart object icon right on the layer. So now it's perfectly ready to start animating. This first animation will be composed of two layers, one of the simple magnification and one that's going to add a little bit of pixelation to give it a little bit more of a realistic feel. So let's start with the simple magnification. Over here in our timeline, we want to go ahead and expand this layer, which is layer one, and we want to look for transform. That's what we're going to be animating first. And to start that animation, you want to click on the stopwatch icon to the left. That'll add a first keyframe. And now you can scrub to the location where you want the animation to stop. I'm going to leave it right about there. And now we can go ahead and make the first transformation. So I'm going to hold down Command or Control and press the letter T on my keyboard to enter free transform mode. And with my Alter option and Shift key held down, I'm going to enlarge this layer nice and large right about there and press Return or Enter on my keyboard to accept the changes. I'm also going to move it somewhere around the top left corner of this image. So that's the first animation. If I go back and scrub through it, you can see it starts there and it enlarges to there. So that's a good start, but I want to add something a little bit extra to give it a little bit more of a realistic feel. We're going to add a mosaic filter. We're going to first add it to this layer with a cell size of 0, and then when we duplicate this layer, we're going to increase it later on. It's a little bit tricky, but it'll probably make sense in a few minutes. So we're going to go up to the filter menu, down to pixelate, and then choose mosaic. Now again, for this one, we're going to set the cell size as low as possible. 2 is the lowest number we can go right now, which is basically a cell size of 0. You can't see much pixelation. We're going to press OK, and now we want to go ahead and duplicate the layer. Usually when you want to duplicate a layer, it's just Command or Control J. But the problem there is if I go ahead and expand this layer, you'll notice that my transformation has disappeared. So we don't want to duplicate it that way. That's basically a layer via copy. We want to duplicate it by going up to the layer menu and then choosing Duplicate Layer. And when I press OK, if we go ahead and expand this, you'll notice I now have my transformations, which is going to save us a lot of time. Now in this layer, I'm going to go ahead and double click on the mosaic filter. This is another reason why you should use smart filters, because you can always go back and change those filters later on. And I'm going to increase my cell size, let's say to around 20. I'm going to press OK. And now if I scrub back, you're going to see a little bit of a problem. We don't want the pixelation to start right from the get-go. We want it to kind of fade in over time. So we want to now animate the opacity. I'm going to scrub over a little bit right around there. We'll have the opacity start animating there. And we want to press the stopwatch right beside opacity. And when we do that, a new keyframe is added. And here, the opacity should be set to 0%. In Photoshop CS6, you can very quickly do that by pressing 0 twice on your keyboard. And then we want to scrub to the endpoint right about there. And now we want to set the opacity back up to 100%, which can be very simply done by pressing 0 once on your keyboard. And now it's at 100% and we now see the pixelation. So if we scrub back to the beginning, you'll see it starts out normally, and then right about there, the pixelation starts to fade in really nicely. So far so good. Now at this point, we want to start the enhancement, which is going to be done on another layer. But it's not going to be a duplicated layer, it's going to be a layer via copy, because this time we don't want to bring over the animations that we've already set. So now we can simply do Command or Control J on the keyboard. And that'll create a copied layer right above with no animations, which is exactly what we want. Now it does contain the mosaic filter. Again, because we're using smart filters, we can always edit this. I'm going to simply drag this filter right down into the trash. And now we can start editing this layer. I'm going to start off by moving it over to the right just a little bit. That'll give a little bit of a pause right after the magnification completes. Now in this layer, we're going to be adding a sharpening filter. And to do that, we're going to go up to Filter, down to Sharpen, and then Unsharp Mask. And we're going to over-enhance it just a little bit. I'm going to set the amount somewhere around, let's say 45%, the radius around 20 pixels, the threshold at 0. I'm going to press OK. Now obviously it shouldn't just appear sharpened, it has to fade in gradually. So we're going to be animating the opacity on this layer. So I'm going to go ahead and expand this new layer. I'm going to press on the stopwatch beside opacity to add a first keyframe. I'm going to set the opacity at 0 by pressing 0 on the keyboard twice. I'm going to scrub a little bit to the right, and I'm going to press 0 to set the opacity back at 100%. So now let's take a look at the animation. Again, it starts off normally, pixelation comes in, there's a little bit of a pause, and then the sharpness starts to appear. But you will notice a little bit of the mosaic is still peeking out from behind. So on that layer, if we scroll down just a little bit in our timeline, I'm going to scrub back to where the sharpening starts, right about there. I'm going to make sure this layer is selected, the layer with the mosaic on it. I'm going to add a keyframe. I'm going to scrub to the end, and I'm going to set the opacity to 0. So now the mosaic will fade out as the sharpening is coming in. So one more time, it starts out normally, pixelation comes in, pause, and then sharpen. And if I scrub back and press the spacebar, it'll all happen at once, which is looking really nice, but we're going to add one more fun little effect. Let me go back up to the top of my timeline, and we're going to add a little bit of an artifact. We want to figure out what this metallic object is. So over at shutterstock.com, I found this image of an alien skull, obviously not a real alien skull, which I've already extracted from the background, and I'm going to go ahead and move it over to this document, place it right about there. Now that's obviously way too big. I'm going to go ahead and convert it into a smart object so I can preserve those pixels. And I'm going to transform it down quite a bit. Command and Control T, Command 0 to make sure I can see everything, and then transform downwards. Let me zoom in so I can see what I'm working with. I'm going to place it somewhere right around there. I don't want it too big. That looks pretty good right there. And I can also go ahead and adjust the perspective. Command and Control T one more time. I'm going to hold down Command and Control and simply adjust the perspective as necessary, just like this. Now obviously this metal object is probably not an alien skull, but we can always pretend. So I'm going to leave it, let's say, right about there. I'm actually going to want to transform it down just a little bit more. Right there. And now we can add some animation to it. And we want the animation to happen as the image is sharpening. So I'm going to make sure in the timeline to line it up with the previous layer, right there. I'm going to go ahead and expand this layer, and we want again to animate the opacity. I'm going to turn on opacity there. Set the opacity at 0%, again, double press on 0, scrub to the endpoint, which you can see down here at the timeline, and press 0 again. So now, starts normal, pixelation, pause, and sharpen with the skull. Now, as you can tell, it doesn't look very realistic, so we're going to make a few changes. We're first going to add a layer mask to blend it in a little bit with the bottom here. You can add a layer mask at the bottom of your layers panel right down there. There's our little layer mask. I'm going to press the B key on my keyboard to enter my brush tool and paint in black, which will hide some of the areas of that skull to make it look like it's kind of embedded in the sand. Good, once that's done, let's add a few adjustment layers to blend it in a little bit more with the background. I'm gonna go ahead and add an adjustment layer. Let's add a brightness and contrast. I'm gonna decrease the brightness a little bit and increase the contrast. Now you're noticing it's applying it to everything. We don't want that. So we wanna click on this icon right here, which is gonna clip it with the previous layer. So now only the skull is being affected. That's perfect, right about there. I'm gonna add one more adjustment layer. I'm gonna add a hue and saturation. Again, make sure to clip it. I'm gonna decrease the saturation, maybe increase the hue a little bit, somewhere right around there, to make sure the colors match up a little bit better than they were before. And the last thing I'm gonna do, because the image is still a little bit blurry, it shouldn't be too sharp, I do wanna go back to this layer, the layer containing the skull, and add a little bit of a Gaussian blur filter. So filter, blur, and then Gaussian blur. Now 2 is probably a little bit too much, so I'm gonna decrease it, let's say to around 1.3, maybe 1.2, maybe 1. Okay, 1 looks pretty good. I'm gonna press OK, and let's go back to the beginning to see how things are progressing. So, it starts off normally. The enhancement starts, pixelation starts. There's a little bit of a pause, enhance. And we now see what that object on Mars really is. Again, it's probably not an alien skull, and if we do hide the skull layer, it looks nothing like a skull. It's probably a strangely formed rock or something that fell off the rover as it was descending. But we can always have a little bit of fun with some CSI type enhancements. Now to finish off the animation, because the animation ends right about here, we're gonna scrub a little bit further, and I'm gonna set my endpoint. This is the endpoint right here. I'm gonna drag it back to the beginning. And now if I scrub back to the beginning, press the space bar, we can see the animation in all its glory. And it will loop if you do have that option enabled under the timelines menu right over here. You can turn on loop playback. Now, in order to save it, what you want to do, you want to go up to the file menu, save for web, and you want to make sure that GIF is selected. Now, it will take a little bit of time to prepare as it is a pretty complex animation and Photoshop has to put everything together. But once it's finished, right at the bottom here, you have looping options. You can choose to loop it once or forever, and when you press save, you can save it to your computer, and then you can upload it to the web for everyone to enjoy. And that just about does it. We've gone ahead and uncovered what that mystery object was on Mars, and of course you can use this technique to enhance pretty much anything like you see in CSI and all those fun TV shows. I hope you guys enjoyed this tutorial. Let me know in the comments down below what you think that mystery object really is, and make sure to check out my other Photoshop tutorials at ICEFLOWSTUDIOS.com. Take care.